Have you ever wanted to learn to play the banjo? Here at Banjo Lemonade, I give you everything you need to learn to play. You can take my stuff and go all the way through songs, jams, anything you'd like. But most of all, let's have fun.
All right, we gotta hurry up. We're fixing to cut loose. Right, Sammy? My special guest who's out of camera.
Hey everybody, beautiful spring day here. I hope it's beautiful where you're at. Anyway, I'm really, really happy today. We got a microphone in the mail. Doing the microphone dance. Anyway, yeah, I got a microphone. Hopefully that'll help with audio issues that I've been having. The jury is still out as to whether or not that's a good thing to hear me louder and clearer. Y'all can let me know in the comments. I'm not too sure if it's a great thing or not. But anyway, yeah, so let's do Go Tell Aunt Rhody. It's a good beginner song to start out with. It's only got two chords. That's a G and a D7. It's played in standard G tuning. That means your fifth string is a G. Your fourth string is a D. Your third string is a G. Second string is a B. And your first string is a D. All right, so to play a G, you don't put anything down on the left hand. It's really fun to play a G. So let's do our basic claw hammer stroke, alternating on the third and fourth string. If you are not familiar with that, go back to Easy Clawhammer Banjo, lessons 1, 2, and 3. You need to get really comfortable with this before you start playing songs. It's just going to help everything if you do. So we're going to be alternating that back and forth. We're going to be using hammer-ons in two spots here. You can leave them out if you're not comfortable with them yet, but start practicing, start trying to throw them in there as you progress. Okay, so our hammer-on will take place during the G chord on the fourth string. So when we're alternating to the fourth string like this, there's 3 4 3 4. When we're alternating to that fourth string, do a hammer-on at the second fret of that fourth string, and you just kind of play with that a little bit while you're doing it. Okay, and we're going to play a D7, and a D7 is your index finger at the second fret, second string, first fret, and your middle finger at the third string, second fret, and our second hammer-on comes there, and we're doing that on our third string when we put that D7 chord down. Okay, so let's hear what the song sounds like. All right, here we go. So you can see it just goes back and forth between the two, and I'll do it slowly for you now. Starts off in G. 7. Tell Aunt G. D. Stay in G. Go tell Aunt Rhody. Now start off in D7. The old gray goose, now back to G, is dead. D7. She's been back to G. Courtin'. The one she's been courtin'. Now go to D7. The old gray goose is back to G. Sorry, there's a bug. Okay, we're going to do a little break also. And that's going to be like this. Okay, that's a little break. It's not too difficult. It's on the fourth string and it's on the third string. It would be difficult if you tried that on the fourth string. Okay, it's on the third string with a 2/4 slide, and there's a lot of stuff happening in that too. And then it's on the second string with just a hammer on to the first fret. Okay, so it starts out like from a 2/4 slide on the third string. And then back to 2, and then open, and then a hammer-on to 2, and then a hammer-on to the second string, first fret, and then open, and then back to the second string, third fret, and then open. Sounds like this. Repeat that again. Then it's hammer on at the third string, second fret. Hammer on to the first fret of the second string. And then second fret of the third string. And then open. Sounds like this. Thank you. I hope you were able to get something out of that. I'm a little hyper today, as you can tell. But yeah, hope you got something out of that. I hope you enjoyed it. Go ahead and hit that like button. If you hadn't already, hit that subscribe. Tap the bell to get notifications on my new videos if you want. That dislike button, no, don't hit that. No, you can hit that if you want. No, really don't hit that. But yeah, I hope you had fun with that. I hope you got something out of it. I hope you have a beautiful, glorious day and enjoy God's glory. And remember, Jesus loves you.